Hey guys, I wanted to talk about, I just beat Control and I just had some alternative endings to the game that I just kind of, cooked up in my head. I find that with Remedy's games, similar to Stephen King, which is they borrow a lot from, they're really good at writing premises, but how you actually finish, the horror story or explaining what that thing is seems to be a really big issue for a lot of these writers. So here's just some things that I kind of created. One, so the normal twist. So the normal twist that at the end would be that Dylan is actually the source of the hiss and pretended to turn himself in and is now in the inner sanctum of the HQ and turns on his real power and controls all the allies, and you have to go in and do like this final assault and free them. And he's, he cites his feelings on resentment, abandonment, and you failing to reach him all these years as his motivation for doing so. And so basically you have to, you have to defeat him, but also get over your idealized version of your brother, this weak little brother that you've been trying to save all this time. You need to mentally destroy that image and then confront him, and then also connect with him to restore control to the Bureau. The second twist that I thought up is the projection twist. So this one's kind of cool. So the Jesse you've been playing of this entire time is an ideal projection in Dylan's mind of his dutiful sister saving him. And that projection in Dylan's mind manifested and was created by the OOP projector and the hiss from his mind. So playing off people's desires and twisting them into reality is basically what has happened. And Jesse is really the entity of the hiss, and you as Dylan are forced to realize this and accept this and spend the other half of the game playing as Dylan hunting down this hiss Jesse and basically bring your sister and the Bureau under your control. So in this scenario, Dylan would be the main character, and I think that'd be a really cool reversal. Number three, the villain twist. For positive. Polaris is actually the source of the hiss, who has called you here to break it free from a control into the wider world. And you break it free from its control, but then you have to defeat it. So the thing that called you here wasn't actually Dylan, but it was Polaris itself. And so it's actually like the source of evil that is actually calling you there to help it escape into the world, but instead you have to defeat it. The variation on Polaris is the other twist, which is number four, which is Polaris is actually the source of this, and you are actually an evil Jesse, and you are called, who has been called there then to impersonate the Bureau director to free Polaris, and you spend the rest of the game hunting down your allies that you met as bosses. So it'd be really cool that you are actually a total like slave and controlled by Polaris, and you actually end up turning against the Bureau and putting it under your control, but it's like an evil Jesse twist. I think that'd be really cool. Another version of that is who the villain is. What if Dr. Darling is actually the source of the hiss? And fueled by lack of recognition for his research, he discovers the OOP machine or the OOP and uses it to assume control of the Bureau and take over the world. And he's actually the bad guy, and you have to defeat him. And I kind of, thought he'd be similar to something like Mikolash of the Nightmare from Bloodborne. So he's summoned this hiss into the world for lack of prestige and whatever. And so he's actually the villain. I think that would be also a viable thing. Another twist I thought of was, what if Director Trench was actually part of Polaris, which is a super consciousness for ESP individuals? And so when he's assassinated or voluntarily suicide, he returned to that collective consciousness to call for outside help to other capable ESP users, being Jesse, who was raised there as a child. And so, because that's the only way he can communicate, because the oldest house has been cut off communication to the outside world. And so you have to come back and bring it under control, as it eventually the hiss would leak out and devour the world, as they've said. There could even be a little backstory where Jesse and Dylan were in this gifted government program and they were at the Bureau as kids and they have to recall their lost memories. I think that would also be cool. I think another twist featuring Trench is that you are actually Director Trench. And the first day on the job, people see you as the director, and Jesse is like your alter ego or a projection of your sister, because you were also actually Jesse's brother, who is actually looking for his kidnapped sister at the bureau. So essentially, Trench would be like Dylan in Jesse's mind, but instead you are projecting Jesse onto like everyone else, because that's also who you're really looking for. And it'd be kind of like a more of an X-Files kind of thing. And finally, the last twist I thought of this game was the dream twist, where the flashbacks where you're a low-level employee and were real, and your abuse in the workplace is actually manifested via OOP into like this power fantasy where you're the director of the bureau now, similar to kind of like Silent Hill. And so you take control of your life and the bureau and build up the courage in the real world to leave your job or something, you know? This makes the least sense, because you were actually working there this whole time and you'd be looking for your brother and be in the intro. It really doesn't work, but I just thought it'd be funny if Jesse was actually just a low-level employee of the bureau and she was just being pushed around and bullied, and this was all happening in her mind, which is just the stupidest one, I'll flat out say. But yeah, these are just some of the ideas I had for Control's ending. I really enjoyed the game. I just wish it had a better like ending. It has a great setup and a great lore and a great universe and great characters, but I feel like it doesn't fully utilize them, and I feel like directly restricts information. So you like, again, we fill the gaps with our own ideas and imagination, but yeah, it's a very cool setting. I really do like it.